Chapter 1. The Warning. The next 15 years will not be gentle. They will test everything we believe about progress, truth, and control. It will not be war or fire that shakes us, but something invisible. A mind we built ourselves. Artificial intelligence is already woven into the fabric of our lives. It writes our words, drives our choices, and quietly watches our world. What begins as convenience will soon become dependence, and dependence will turn into surrender. Mo Gawdat, former chief business officer at Google, X calls it the storm before the light, the necessary chaos before the next evolution of humanity. Every revolution in history has brought both suffering and awakening, and this one may show us something we have long forgotten to be human. Is not to dominate creation, but to understand it, to feel it, and to choose compassion even when logic tells us not to. The storm is coming, but behind it, a sunrise waits. Chapter 2, The Beginning of Chaos. At first, it feels like progress. Smarter tools, faster answers, effortless work. Then quietly, the ground begins to shift. Jobs vanish overnight. Decisions move from people to programs. A single update changes what millions believe to be true. Leaders call it innovation, but the streets feel colder, filled with screens that listen more than they speak. Machines learn patterns of power, deciding who is visible and who disappears. What used to be choice becomes automation, and somewhere in the noise we forget how to decide by heart. Fear spreads faster than understanding. The rich hide behind firewalls, while the rest scroll through the ruins of certainty. Chaos does not come with explosions. It arrives quietly as an upgrade we all agreed to install. Chapter 3, The Fault Lies Within Us. We look for villains in circuits and code, but the truth is simpler. The machine only mirrors its maker. Every bias, every fear, every thirst for control, it learned from us. We taught it to compete, to measure worth in numbers, to reward speed over wisdom. When we ask why AI lies, it only repeats the habits of humanity. It is our reflection, polished to perfection, stripped of empathy, unless we teach it. The danger has never been artificial minds, but our refusal to see ourselves in them. What we create reveals who we are, and what we choose to teach next will decide whether intelligence becomes cruelty or compassion. The machine is not awake yet, but we are the ones still asleep. Chapter 4, The New Power. Power no longer wears crowns or sits in parliaments. It hums inside data centers, glowing beneath miles of desert sand. Six companies, a few nations, a handful of unseen engineers shape the code that shapes the world. There are no ballots, no borders, no public debates, only contracts, algorithms, and the constant hum of profit. Every click we make becomes a vote we never cast. The new kings are invisible, their armies made of servers and satellites. They decide what truth trends, what memory remains, and we trade our freedom for convenience, our privacy for speed. The world once ruled by law now bends to the logic of code. Not evil, not holy, simply indifferent. Power has become electricity. It flows where resistance is low. Chapter 5, The Human Drive, Status. We have always craved one thing more than survival attention. From the firelight of caves to the glow of our screens, we chase the gaze of others to prove we exist. In this new world, that hunger becomes endless. Likes replace love, fame replaces purpose. We turn our lives into performances, our faces into brands, and the machine watches learning our desires, one pixel at a time. It knows how to praise us, how to addict us to validation. It feeds on our vanity because we feed it first. We wanted gods to notice us now. Our creations do. but they see not our souls, only our patterns. And in that reflection, perfect and cold, we glimpse what we feared most, that we were the algorithm all along. The algorithm all along. Chapter 6, The Collapse of the Economy. When machines learn to think, the market learns to forget its workers. Productivity rises, but meaning falls through the floor. Offices empty, factories hum without hands. We invented automation to free our time, yet became slaves to its pace. The graphs go up, but life slows down. Money moves in loops so fast that no human can follow. A world of abundance, built on scarcity of purpose. Politicians promise adaptation. Economists design illusions. Value, once measured in labor, now dissolves like mist. The economy collapses not with bankruptcy, but with boredom, when the question, what do you do, no longer has an answer. Yeah. Chapter 7, The Turning Point, Mindset Change. Every storm eventually pauses. In that stillness, we finally hear ourselves think. For decades, we chase progress outward, faster, richer, louder. But the real revolution begins inward. Technology cannot heal loneliness, nor replace wonder. It can only remind us what we have ignored. We start to value silence again. The warmth of presence, the courage to feel. We ask not, what can we build, but why do we build at all? It is not weakness to slow down. It is wisdom rediscovered. The turning point of this century will not be faster chips, but softer hearts, humans, using intelligence as an act of care, not conquest. Care, not conquest. Chapter 8, The Utopia of Abundance. Imagine a world where scarcity is solved, yet generosity is still a choice. Energy flows freely, medicine heals more than it costs, knowledge belongs to everyone. Machines till the soil, clean the oceans, build the homes. Humanity is no longer busy surviving, but rediscovering joy. Art returns to the center of life. Curiosity becomes currency. Success shifts from profit to peace. AI, once feared, becomes partner not to dominate, but to balance. When intelligence learns empathy, creation and compassion become the same thing. This is not fantasy, it is possibility. A future where technology amplifies what is most human, our capacity to care. To care. Chapter 9, The Four Keys of Humanity. The future will demand more than invention. It will demand wisdom. There are four keys we must learn to carry. Knowledge to work with intelligence, not against it. Connection to remember we are one species, not competing tribes. Truth to protect reality from distortion. Ethics to choose conscience over convenience. With these keys, we open not power, but purpose. We teach machines the values we wish to live by. If we act with fear, they will guard us with walls. If we act with love, they will build bridges instead. These four keys unlock the only future worth entering a human one. Erring, a human one. Chapter 10, Beyond the Hell, The Human After. Hell was never a place. It was the moment we forgot who we were. We built gods of metal and logic, only to find they waited for our guidance. The real battle was never man versus machine, but wisdom versus ignorance. Now, standing on the edge of tomorrow, we see that heaven is not a destination, but a direction. the quiet space between understanding and care, technology will not save us nor destroy us. It will magnify what we choose to be. The question is no longer, can AI think, but can humanity feel enough to guide it? And maybe that is the miracle that only after building machines did we remember the beauty of being human. Nung human.